Drew Scott, welcome back to Malta Watchery. Now we have the bow review of the Taylor bow, the Hungarian bow. I strung it already, as shown in the unboxing video. It's a really nice bow. Look at these long sears, reinforced here, tips, the limbs, and leather and decoration on the back, and with the special secret ingredients on the fiberglass limbs that it looks like horn. We have a nice picando, it fits perfectly in my hand. This is how the bow looks like. The bow is 58 inches from nock to nock, unstrung, and the string has a length of 51 inches from loop to loop. This one is a 40 pounder, and the max draw, as mentioned, 31 inches. Now let's shoot this. So, of course, I need to mention these bows made from Taylor bow are all a little on the heavy side, because of the material, you know, it's fiberglass and synthetic resin, so it weighs a bit, but it's not distracting, disturbing. So. It's a quite fast shooter, draws very smooth. It's fast, smooth. Now let's shoot Mediterranean, because Hungarians shoot Mediterranean. Just through. Nice too. You feel a little vibration in the handle, and you feel the handle slightly working, slightly bending. But this is, I think, due to the material. You can't change that with this bow, but even the hand shock is not that heavy that it would be disturbing or something. I shoot three more arrows. One more time. A little heavy. This nice shake. Huh? All the limbs nearly bent backwards. A wonderful piece of art. If you're looking for a really historically looking bow, like horn, leather with a nice decoration, and you have no problem that this bow is a little heavier, it's not really heavy, and the bow has slightly vibration in the handle, then this is a really wonderful bow. Maybe if you shoot heavier arrows, I don't know the weight of my arrows, they are sort of 500 grain. When you shoot maybe heavy arrows, even the vibration maybe is not there anymore. But look at this, it looks awesome. I like this bow a lot. Thank you very much, Paul, for these wonderful bows. See you soon with the next review of his Turkish bow.